सदाशिवसमारंभां शंकराचार्यमध्यमास्मदाचार्यपर्यन्तां वन्दे गुरुपरम्परां श्रुतिस्मृतिपुराणानामालयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वन्दे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेदविभागिनी व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै ॐ शान्तिश्शान्तिश्शान्तिः योगब्रह्माणिजातिगुरुवेदांश्च प्रणोति तस्मै तगुंहृदयमात्मबुद्धिप्रकाशं मुमुक्षुरुवै शरणमहं प्रपद्येऽं शान्तिश्शान्तिश्शान्तिः आम्नायन्तिं संसिद्धमादिमध्यान्तवर्जितमानन्दघनमापूर्णमात्मज्योतिरुपास्महे We looked at the first sutra in the first pada of the third adhyaya. Tadantara pratipatto rauhati samparishvaktaha prashna nirupanabhyam. So due to the question and answer as seen in the Upanishad, in the Panchagni Vidya, rauhati gachati, who samparishvaktaha jiva, the jiva who is connected with the భూత సూక్ష్మ ది సూక్ష్మ శరీర హీ ట్రాన్స్మైగ్రేట్స్ తదంతర ప్రతిపత్తు దేహాంతర ప్రాప్తు వైల్ అటైనింగ్ ది వెన్ అటైనింగ్ ది సెపరేట్ దేహ అనదర్ దేహ వైల్ అటైనింగ్ అనదర్ దేహ దిస్ జీవ ఈజ్ సంపరిశక్త కనెక్టెడ్ విత్ ది సూక్ష్మ శరీర నను నౌ ది క్వశ్చన్ దేర్ ఇస్ నను एवं अद्विहि संपरिष्वक्तः गच्छति इति गम्यते कथं तद् इतरभूत परिष्वंगः परिष्वंग सिद्धिः तत्राह पूर्वपक्षी सेज ओके व्हाट यू हैव प्रेजेंटेड इज दैट दी जीवा इज संपरिष्वक्त युक्ता विथ व्हाट जल अद्विहि विथ आप विथ दी अपतत्व और दी जलतत्व बिकॉज वॉट हैज बीन सेड दी पंचम्याम आहुता आहुता वापह मीन्स पंचम्याम आहुतौ आपह पुरुष वचसः भवन्ति सो देयर बाय ओनली जला इज मेंशन्ड हाउ डू यू मेक अ जंप टू भूत सूक्ष्मास अदर भूत सूक्ष्मास ओनली जला यू कैन से दी जीवा इज endowed with jala, jala tattva, but not the others. So, nanu evam advihi samparishvaktah gacchati iti gamyate. By that mantra, it is known that the jiva who transmigrates, travels, is connected with jala tattva. Katham tad itarabhuta parishvangah siddhi. How is it that this jiva is said to be connected with other bhuta sukshmas? Why not only jala? Tatraha, the sutrakara se triatmakatvat bhuyastvat, triatmakatvat bhuyastvat. So this has been mentioned earlier. Jala tattva is there, which is panchikrita jala tattva. Therefore, the other four mahabhutas are part of jala tattva. It is not sukshma jala. It is the सूक्ष्म अंश और सटल पार्ट ऑफ दी ऑलरेडी ग्रॉसिफाइड महाभूत इन द फॉर्म ऑफ जला नाउ सो जला इज नॉट ओनली जला जला ऑल्दो जला हैज 50% ऑफ इटसेल्फ बट दी अदर्स आर ऑल्सो देयर हाफ ऑफ जला एंड दी अदर फोर आर 25% ईच देयर बाय मीनिंग 25% ऑफ दी 50% मीनिंग 12.5% Other Mahabhuta are also there, therefore it is not only endowed with, the Jiva is not only endowed with Jala Tattva, but with other Mahabhutas also. Because Trivutkarnam, Panchikarnam or Trivutkarnam, if you say Trivutkarnam, then the other two, meaning Prithvi Tattva and Agni Tattva are also there, and thereby Jiva is connected with all three, and by extension all five Mahabhutas, which are भौतिका नाउ भौतिका इन द सेंस दे आर ग्रॉसिफाइड नॉट भौतिका सेम दी सूक्ष्म तत्व भौतिक ऑल्सो वी कैन से सो सूक्ष्म शरीर त्रयात्मकत्वा तू बिकॉज ऑफ दी जला इट्सेल्फ बीइंग त्रयात्मक इन दी फॉर्म ऑफ थ्री महाभूतास तू भूयस्त्वात एंड भूयस्त्वात मीन जलस्य भूयस्त्वात जला इज मोर बट डज नॉट मीन द अदर टू आर नॉट देयर अदर अग्नि एंड पृथ्वी महाभूतास आर ऑल्सो देयर त्रिवृत्करण श्रुत्या अपाम इतर भूत द्वय मेलनेन त्रयात्मकत्वात why do we say that the jiva is connected with the other mahabhutas also because trivutkarna shruti says that jala tattva apam itara bhuta dvaya melaneena tryatmakatva it says that jala tattva is tryatmaka is in the form of agni jala and prithvi all three because of itara bhuta dvaya melana how has it become threefold not threefold rather how has it become grossified jala itself by mixing up with the other two bhutas itara bhuta dvaya melaneena tryatmakatvam kasya kesham or kasam apam strilinga so apam tryatmakatvat by itara bhuta dvaya meaning agni and prithvi melana katham tari shrutau apshabdah then why अपशब्द हैज बीन यूज इन दी श्रुति वाई डिड श्रुति से पंचम्याम आहुताव आपः पुरुष वचसो भवन्ति सो दी श्रुति कुड हैव सेड ऑल थ्री इट टॉक्स ओनली अबाउट जला वाई सो देर सिद्धांति सेज दैट भूयस्त्वात् तेज आदि अपेक्षया अपाम देहे भूयस्त्वात् इत्यर्थ बिकॉज यू सी इन दी बॉडी Jala is more. There is a lot of water in the body. Science also accepts that the body has lot of proportion of water. In fact, those who want to explain how in Jyotisha it is said that the phases of the moon affects the person. So scientifically also it can be said as to the phases of the moon. Affect the water and body has lot of water therefore if the moon can affect the samudra why can't moon affect the water in a human or any other body thereby the progression of the moon the movements of the moon will also affect the sharira affect the person so thereby jyotisha also can be established by astrology can be established by astronomy So this is how the presence of water in a huge quantity compared to others has been taken into account by the Shruti when it makes the statement of jala with jala because bhuyastva teja adi apeksha compared to the tejas tattva and the in trivrutkaranam prithvi alone but Others also you can take panchi with panchikaranam you can take the vayu and akash also compared to that jala is more in the sharira apam dehe bhuyastvat ityartha therefore shruti also uses the example of jala pranagatescha and also due to pranagati what does it mean also due to pranagati short sutra short vritti so we look at the vritti prananam tam utkramantam इत्यादिना भूत आश्रितानामेव गतेः श्रवणात् तत् संपरिश्वंग सिद्धिः बिकॉज ऑफ द प्राणगति ऑल्सो इन दी श्रुति तम उत्क्रांतम इत्यादिना तम प्राणम उत्क्रांतम इत्यादिना सेइंग दैट प्राणानाम गतेः श्रवणात् बिकॉज ऑफ हियरिंग दिस प्राण प्राण तत्व As and prana there means what? Indriya shruti. It is indriya. So when prana goes, then the indriyas also leave. It has been mentioned. Ityadina bhuta ashrita anam eva gate he. So gati is of those indriyas meaning the not in the prana samvada, but when the jiva leaves, when the jiva leaves, the indriyas leave along with the prana, the sukshma sharira leaves and the jiva also leaves. So what is this adhara for prana gateshcha kim? So this is not saying, this is not answering the question as to padvi samparishukta gacchati iti, and why not say only jala, but you are claiming that the jiva is connected with the other mahabhutas also. That was the question asked, but it is not answering that. In fact, it is answering what? It is saying that the entire set of whatever parts are there in the sukshma sharira, they leave. So that is the shruti pramana as to tam utkrantam. There is a typo there. Tam utkramantam. No, it is right. So tam utkramantam ityadina, that shruti says what? The sukshma sharira, which has indriyas also and all the other things, they leave. With indriyas are bhautikas, they are the products of bhutas, and it is not only jala that is the mahabhuta which has created rasana indriya. Others are also there, other indriyas which are the products of other four mahabhutas, thereby tamut utkramantam. Indriyas also leave while the jiva is leaving the sharira, and thereby prananam gatehe, because of indriyas are also heard to leave the sharira on mrityu, and that set of indriyas are part of the sukshma sharira, and they are bhautika, they are bhuta sukshma. When you look at all the indriyas, they are products of all the mahabhutas ityadina bhutashritanam eva gatehe. So indriyas are bhutashrita, they cannot travel unless you are saying that the jiva is connected. Jiva is traveling, prana is leaving the sharira, jiva is leaving the sharira, sukshma sharira, indriyas are following the jiva. Gatehe means shravanat. Tat samparishvanga siddhihi, and thereby the connection or endowment with the indriyas is established. Jiva is one who is samparishvaktaha. With what? With all the sukshma, bhuta sukshmas or sukshma sharira angas. In continuation, what? Agnyadi gati shruteir iti chenna bhaktatvat. Agnyadi gati shrutehe iti chet na bhaktatvat. So Purvapakshi says, what about this agnyadi shruti? Agnyadi shrutehe iti chet na bhaktatvat. Bhaktatvat means gaunatvat, because it is gauna. Says that bhaktatvat, because of the shruti, agnyadi shruti being gauna. So what is the Purvapakshi claiming? Agnyadi gati shruti. That agnyadi gati shruti says that the travel is due to what? The agnyadi devata, who is the adhishtatru devata of the travel there. So gati is what? Due to agnyadi devatas. The agnyadi devatas are leading the jiva. So therefore what? Iti chet. Therefore what? You claim the Siddhanti, that is not right. Because what happens in mrityu, indriyas are leaving, but indriya is, let's say the chakshur indriya is leaving. Chakshur indriya is adhishtatru devata, and then some other indriyas, adhishtatru devata, they are all presiding. Thereby these adhishtatru devatas, agnyadi, are also there, who are leading the jiva, leading the indriyas. The indriyas are going due to that reason, and then connection with jiva is not established. Just because indriyas are leaving, the presiding deities or other deities who are leading, who are supposed to be leaders of these indriyas, they are carrying the indriyas. thereby jiva's connection with the indriyas is not established after mrityu, and thereby your claim does not seem to be right, says the Purvapakshi. Why? It has the agnyadi gati shruti is the pramana there, says the Purvapakshi. Siddhanti says no, bhaktatvat, that shruti is gauna, it is not in its mukhya meaning. The shruti that is looked into by the Purvapakshi is quoted in the vritti, mrutasya agnim vag apyeti vatam pranaha ityadina agnyadishu gati shrutehe laya shravanat. So how is this travel possible? Indriyas have laya in the devatas. So mrutasya, the person who is dead, mrutasya agnim vak apyeti vak, mrutasya vak, the speech meaning the vagindriya of the mruta purusha, agnim apyeti, it attains agni meaning has laya in agni devata. And then what about this pranaha vatam apyeti, prana merges with the vata, vayu devata. So agni devata, vayu devata, these all devatas where the respective indriyas have merged, they are ones who cause this travel. There is no talk of jiva there at all. Ityadina agnyadishu gatishrutehe. So agnyadishu gatishrutehe layashravanat, because of this reason that agnyadi unto agni ityadi devatas gati, indriya gati is not with the jiva, indriya gati is unto the devatas, tattat devatas, and thereby layashravanat, that becomes a hetu. Indriyanam layashravanat, kutra asti laya, indriyanam layaha. So indriyanam laya agnyadishu devatasu asti, therefore what? Na jivena vagadayah gacchanti iti chet. Therefore the claim made by the Siddhanti as to jiva is connected with the indriyas, and how do you know that? Because indriyas travel following this jiva has been said. There is no such connection at all, because indriyas have already attained laya into agnyadi devatas. Iti chet na, Siddhanti says no, that is not true. Why? Vagadi laya shrutehe aushadhir lomani iti vatu bhaktatvad ityartha. Siddhanti says you have to do a mimamsa. Whenever there is some kind of a virodha, then Puro Mimamsa has already given how to understand the tatparya there. So you have to do mimamsa there, you have to analyze. And in analysis you see that jiva is one who was endowed with the indriyas, then it makes sense that when jiva is leaving, indriyas leave along with him. They are subtle. Just because you do not see doesn't mean that they are not traveling. Jiva is subtle, indriyas are subtle, and jiva by very definition is one who is connected with this sukshma sharira, which includes indriyas. And what about this mrutasya agni vag apyeti vatam prana ityadi? To that the Siddhanti says that vagadi laya shruti, that vagadi laya shruti is gauna. Why? It is similar to the aushadhir lomani. If you look at it, lomani, the body hair are compared with aushadhi, with the herbs or the plants or trees, you look at them. So the hair that grows from the skin is compared to the trees that grow off the, or the shrubs which grow off the ground. Is it really so? It is a comparison, it's a gauna shruti. So the laya is also gauna there. It is not that the indriyas are going to resolve in the agnyadi devatas really. So bhaktatva iti vat bhaktatvat, it is gauna. Prathame shravanaditi chenna ta eva shubhapattehe. Prathame shravanaditi chenna ta eva shubhapattehe. In continuation, prathame ashravanat, Purvapakshi is saying prathame ashravanat, this is not been heard earlier. meaning prathamasthana. In prathamasthana, there is no shravana. We'll see what that means in the vritti. Iti chet na ta eva hi upapatte he. The padachede prathame ashravanat iti chet na ta taha eva hi upapatte he. Taha eva, meaning prathame means what? Here in panchagni vidya what has been said, whatever was taught by the Raja, Panchala Raja not to Shvetaketu, but he asked Shvetaketu and then he taught his father when the father approached with humility. In the Prathama Agni, there are 5 Ahutis in the Panchagni Vidya in 5 respective Agnis, which were said as what? Jiv, Parjanya, Prithvi, Purusha, Yoshit. These are the 5 Agnis unto which Shraddha, Soma, Vrishti, Anna and Reta were offered. Thereby the Jiva has this journey across 5 Ahutis and finally from Retas the Jiva is taking birth in a particular Sharira form. So this unto Dhyu, Shraddha is offered. There Ashravanat Prathame in the Dhyula Lokagni, there is Ashravana, there is no Shravana of what? Of Jala. Apam Ashravanat. So Prathame means Dhyulokagnav. In that Ahuti of the Dhyuloka, which is offered in the Dhyuloka first. What is the offering there? Shraddha is the offering, Jala is not the offering. So Apam Ashravanat, Jalasya Ashravanat iti chet na. So there Shraddha is offered, this Jiva, how is he connected with the Mahabhutas? He is not connected with the Mahabhutas because when he has the journey of coming back, taking Janma, that time this Jiva is not seen to be connected with the Mahabhutas because Shraddha is the offering there. Jala is in the 5th. So where is it that, how do you claim that the Jiva is connected with the Jala Ityadi Mahabhutas? It is not heard in the first Ahuti there. So when the Jiva comes back, he is not connected with the Jala Tattva at all. He is connected with what? Shraddha is offered. So thereby Prathame Ashravanat Jalasya or Apam Ashravanat Iti Chet Na. Why? Taeva. The Shraddha which is mentioned. Taeva. Meaning the Taha Apaha Eva. Because Jala or Apshabda. Apshabda is in the Jala meaning, but it is Nitya Strilinga and Nitya Bahuvachana. Therefore, Taeva Apaha Eva what? He Upapatte He. Because what is meant by the in the first Ahuti also, it is that Jalatattva alone, meaning the Mahabhutas which are grossified and now in the form of Jala, that itself is meant because of tenability. Upapattehe hetoho. How so? We'll see more in the vritti. Dhyulokadi panchagnishu prathame dhyulokagnau tasmin etasmin agnau devashraddham johati. So the mantra there in Panchagni Vidya is what? Devaha, the devas offer Shraddha, Shraddham Juhati, they offer Shraddha. Unto what? Tasmin Netasmin Agnav, in that which is now explained in the current context as this Agni. In this Agni, which is that? Dhyuloka. So Dhyuloka is in the form of Agni, Tasmin, that Dhyuloka which is well known, which is now here mentioned as Dhyuloka, unto this Dhyuloka, which is in the form of the Agni, devas offer Shraddha as oblation. Iti Shraddhayaha Ahutitva Shravanat Apam Ashravanat. Puro Pakshi says, there Shraddha is offered as Ahuti and Jala Apaha, they are not offered. That is not heard in the mantra Katham Purushavachastvam Iti Chet. then how do you jump to this jiva? In fact, the jiva itself is not mentioned. Jala is not mentioned and jiva is not mentioned. So how in the end you are saying that this jiva is connected with jala, and that same jiva in mrityu has to be connected with jala, and meaning the indriyas, the jala karya, jala adi mahabhuta karya. So all these you have to see in the sambandha, in the karana and karya connection. Mahabhutas, their subtle amshas, mahabhutas have given rise to each subtle indriya, and jiva is said to be connected with them. Now if jiva is connected with them, then jiva should be mentioned, the mahabhuta should be mentioned in the entire journey, and that entire journey is talked about in the panchagni vidya. Therefore neither is the jiva mentioned there nor jala is mentioned. So where is this jiva? Purusha vachastu, how does this name purusha come from the jala tattva which is offered in the fifth ahuti? It is not mentioned at all in the first ahuti. So where is this jiva at all? How do you say that is jiva journey? Jiva journey is being mentioned, and thereby the question is raised by the Purvapakshi. So jala is not purusha sanyaka at all. So jala does not have purusha sanya, which is not given in the first ahuti. Iti chet na. Siddhanti says no, you should not raise such an objection. Why? He, yataha, he is this, he upapatte, he is in the meaning of yasmat. Yasmat, yataha, yasmat, karana, apaha, apo hasmai shraddham sannamante. Iti shraddha shabdena. Elsewhere what is mentioned? In another mantra, Aitariya. All these are this Panchagni Vidya in Chandogya Upanishad. Tasmine tasmin agnav deva shraddham juhati ityadi. And Purvapakshi is objecting the shraddha shabda is not jala, is not in the meaning of jala. And then how is it that jala has got this name as purusha, purusha vachastvam? Siddhanti says that you have to read the Aitariya mantra together. In Aitariya Upanishad, apo hasmai shraddham sannamante, such mantra is there. Because it has been said, what has been said? Apaha ha asmai shraddham sannamante. Meaning for the purpose of punya, what does the yajamana do? He offers jala. Ha asmai, ha, definitely it is so that asmai unto this what? Apaha. He offers jala. Yajamana offers jala. And then what does he get as a result? From jala offering, he gets shraddha. Shraddham sannamante. He attains jala. This offering jala, he attains shraddha. So for the purpose of shraddha, what does the yajamana do in the ahuti there? He offers jala. So from jala, shraddha is utpanna. Therefore, jala and shraddha sambandha is very clear in that mantra, Aitariya mantra. Thereby, iti shraddha shabdena tadhetavaha. Taha is mentioned in the Mula. So tadhetavaha taha eva apaha lakshyante. What is the hetu for Shraddha? You see in Aitariya, hetu for Shraddha is Jala itself. So when Shraddha is offered by Devas in the Prathama Ahuti of the Panchagnis, in the Panchagni Vidya, in the first Agni, which is Dyuloka of the Dyuloka form, unto which Shraddha is offered, meaning what? Tadhetu Jala itself. Shraddha hetu is jala. It is already known in from another mantra. Iti shraddha shabdena tad hetava means shraddha hetavaha, which are those taha eva apaha, those very meaning apaha, meaning that very jala, that very water is mentioned by the word shraddha lakshyante. That is what is meant by the word shraddha in the first offering also, prathame also. Therefore shraddhayaha shravanat apam tu ashravana, that claim cannot be made at all, because Shraddha itself is what? has its hetu in jala. Jala gives rise to shraddha as it is seen in Aitariya mantra. Ataha prashna nirupanayoho upapattehe charta. Therefore upapattehe, it is a tenability of this question being answered in this manner. There have been so many interactions in the Shruti, you have to read them together, and thereby it is established that then alone this question and answer between the Shvetaketu's father and what? And the Panchala Raja will make sense when you put them all together as to Shraddha is Jalahetu, and by offering Shraddha in the first Ahuti and Retas in the fifth Ahuti, Jiva is born. So Jiva is seen in the form of being connected with the Jala, which is Trivrutkrita, Panchikrita, and thereby connected with the all the Bhuta Sukshmas. Atha Prashna Nirupanayoho Upapatte Rityartha. Ashrutatva Diti Chen Na Ishtadi Karinam Pratitehe. Ashrutatvaditi chen neshtadi karinam pratitehe. Sutra should not be broken, but then it's difficult to chant and then read the vritti together. Sometimes there is a confusion as to which is chanted and which is to be read. So ashrutatvat iti chet, because of not being heard. Ashrutatvat iti chet na इष्टादि कारिणाम प्रतीते हे. सो दिस जीवा ट्रेवलिंग बीइंग कनेक्टेड विद जलादि महाभूतास इज नॉट हर्ड सेज द पूर्वपक्षी अश्रुतत्वात् इति चेत् दैट इज नॉट राइट सेज द सिद्धांति. वाई? Because this ishtadi, ishta purti ityadi karma, which are going to generate punya, that has been heard. The ishtadi kari, jiva who is, or jivas, multiple, karinam. So ishta purta karma kari, who is that jiva? So tesham jivanam, ishtadi karinam jivanam pratitehe. This jiva travels. Why would he do ishtadi, ishta purti ityadi karmas? Why would this jiva do such karma at all? He is doing it because he knows that he is going to get a travel to another loka where there is punya phala prapti. Just let me make a correction. This Aushadhir Lomani, that mantra, that Aushadhir Lomani, I said that comparison with, the comparison is other way around as to what? The Lomas become Aushadhi. It is not the mantra there, because the comparison is what? The Purvapakshi has said, Mrutasya Agni Vag Apyeti. In a similar section, what has been said? Aushadir Lomani, meaning the Lomas, hair of the dead person, Mrutasya Lomani, they are not compared. They are said that they become. So the comparison that I stopped at the comparison, but what is the comparison? It is amounting to the mantra meaning literally as what? These hairs of the hair on the body of the person, which person? The dead person, they become aushadi, they become these shrubs. It is not true that they become trees ityadi. So the comparison is not simita to what I explained earlier as to like the hair grows from the skin, it is similar to the plants growing off the ground. That comparison is there, but using such simile, there is an arthavada saying that the hair of the dead person become the shrubs. You don't see that. It is not literal. It is not in the literal meaning. What it has said is that it has laya in the ground. After cremation, you don't see the separation of the hair from bhasmi bhuta sharira. So it is all Gauna. So that was the Bhaktattvam there. The I didn't complete the meaning of the example given by the Siddhanti to establish Bhaktattvam or Gaunattvam of the Vagadi Laya Shruti. So returning to our sixth mantra, current context. Ashrutatvaditi chet, the jivas travel with the indriyas is not heard. Jiva, so there the Siddhanti says that indriyas are a means to bhoga, meaning the antakarana, finally what this bhuta sukshma is that which put together makes a jiva have anubhava. It makes possible for the jiva to have anubhava only when he is connected with the sukshma sharira. Now this kind of a jiva does not travel, if that is the claim. Why? Ashrutatvat. Siddhanti says no. Why? Ishtadikarinam pratitehe. Because you see clearly that Ishtadikari is there, who is the jiva, and through that you know that indriyas have to travel, meaning he should be connected with the bhuta sukshma. So this jiva who has traveled to another loka for karma phala bhoga, and the example given is ishtadi, ishta purta ityadi karmas which have been said that one should do it. Those who do perform such ishtadi karmas, they will attain swargadi lokas, whichever loka, and thereby they will attain sukha. So by that you know that this jiva is traveling the way we have established, being connected with the bhuta sukshmas. And thereby pratitehe, due to such an understanding, it is but proper to say that jiva is one, the jiva gamana, which jiva gamana? This jiva who is samparishvakta with the bhuta sukshmas. This is the Siddhanti's answer. So jivasya ashrutatvaditi chet, jiva meaning the jiva as claimed by the Siddhanti, who is connected with the bhuta sukshma, that is the jiva. So tadrupa jivasya ashrutatvat gamana, when it gamana is heard, tatra ashrutatvaditi chet na, why ishtapurta karma karinam pratitehe, because it is known through the jiva who is the karta of ishtapurta ityadi karma as recommended by the shruti, as prescribed by the shruti, and therefore for bhoga he has to travel with all his tools which make experience possible. Shraddha shabditanam apam purushavachastve api tad veshtitattvam jivasya na yujyate. Purva Pakshi is objecting that this jiva cannot be endowed with avadi mahabhutas which are trivritkruta panchikruta. So shraddha shabdita, jala shabda, apshabda made be shraddha shabdita, meaning may the jala be the meaning of shraddha in the first ahuti, shraddha shabda. And thereby these jalas, meaning apam, purusha vachastvam, and thereby even if the first offering is shraddha, in the final offering this jiva is one who, jiva is one who is called as Purusha. So Purusha is a name given to what? To Jala. So although in the fifth ahuti, Jala gets the name of Purusha, and you are claiming that the Shraddha Shabda is in the meaning of Jala in the first ahuti, let it be so. Even so, what? Tadveshtitattvam jivasya na yujyate. But jiva being connected with the bhuta sukshmas, that itself is not right. That cannot be the meaning there. Why? Abadivad jivasya api, not api, abadivad jivasya ashrutatva iti chet. So this jiva who is traveling, that kind of a jiva is not heard. The way you claim, apshabda is also not heard, and jiva shabda is not heard, or rather purusha vachastva is there for apshabda, but apshabda may be heard there. Abadi vat jivasya ashrutatva. So अपशब्द इज हर्ड बट जीव शब्द इज नॉट हर्ड. अबाधिवत अश्रुतत्वात् कस्य जीवस्य, सो जीव इज नॉट हर्ड. सो यू कैन से ओके अबाधि शब्द आर ट्रेवलिंग, श्रद्धा श्रद्धा इज ट्रेवलिंग, जीवा दी अपशब्द गेट्स दी पुरुषा एज दी नेम, बट जीवा इज नॉट मेंशन्ड एनीवेयर इन दोज मंत्रास. पंचाग्नि विद्या हैज नो मेंशन ऑफ जीवा देर. सो जीवस्य अश्रुतत्वात् इति चेत् न. सो इन द ट्रेवल ऑफ दी जीवा, गति ऑफ दी जीवा एंड द रिवर्स गति, वेन दी जीवा इज सेट टू बी बॉर्न, युअर क्लेम इज पंचाग्नि विद्या इज ए प्रमाण देर, एंड देर देर फॉर यू आर सेइंग द जीवा इज कनेक्टेड विद दी सूक्ष्म भूतास, भूत सूक्ष्मास. सो आई एग्री दैट श्रद्धा शब्द हैज द मीनिंग ऑफ जला, एंड जला गेट्स द नेम ऑफ पुरुष इन द पंचम आहुति. इन द फर्स्ट आहुति श्रद्धा मीन्स जला इटसेल्फ, एंड द फिफ्थ आहुति दैट जला गेट्स द नेम ऑफ पुरुष. बट वेर इज द मीनिंग ऑफ, वेर इज द वर्ड जीवा यूज? दिस इज द ऑब्जेक्शन बाय द पूर्वपक्षी. अबाधिव जीव से अश्रुतत्वात् इति चेत् न सेज सिद्धांति कुतः. अथ य इमे ग्राम इष्टापूर्ते दत्तमित्युपासते ते धूमम अभिसंभवन्ति इत्यादि वाक्यशेषेण इष्टापूर्तकर्मकारिणां प्रतीतेरित्यर्थः. ही सेज जीवा मीनिंग हैज टू बी अंडरस्टूड. वाई? बिकॉज इन दिस पंचाग्नि विद्या फ्रॉम दिस द्यूलोका, दिस स्वर्ग स्वर्गादि लोका, द्यूलोका इटसेल्फ, विल टेक ओनली द्यूलोका एज द स्वर्गलोका. हू इज रीचिंग दिस द्यूलोका? Shraddha is offered, which has the meaning of jala, all that is all right. And in the panchamahuti, the jala itself gets the name of purusha. This much you are accepting. Why are you not accepting jiva? Because you say that jiva shabda has not been used. Siddhanti says, but it is jiva alone whose travel is being talked about there. Why? Because अथय इमे ग्राम इष्टापूर्ते दत्तम इत्युपासते ते धूमम अभिसंभवन्ति. सो दिस धूमादि मार्ग ट्रेवल, ऑल दैट ट्रेवल इज मेंशन्ड फॉर हूम? फॉर द जीवा अलोन. हू हैज डन व्हाट? द इष्टापूर्ति कर्म, इष्टापूर्ति इत्यादि कर्म हैज बीन डन बाय जीवा, एंड दैट जीवा अलोन इज ट्रेवलिंग, नॉट एनीवन एल्स. And what does this mean? Athaya ime gram, grame. Grame here has the meaning of grahastaha. So athaya ime grama, grahastaha. These grahastaha what? Ichtapurte dattam ityupasate. So they do upasana in which manner? That ishtapurte dattam, I have given ishta and purti. Ishta and purta, I have given ishtapurti, I have given. In this manner, upasate, te dhumam abhisavvanti, they attain this dhuma marga. So, ityadi vakyasheshena, there is a vakyashesha there. Ityadi vakyasheshena kim? Ishtapurta karma karinam pratitehe. Ityartha. So, who are being discussed there as having this travel? The mantra clearly says that athaya ime, who are these? The very जीवास हु हैव डन इष्टापूर्त कर्म. द मंत्र देर इज इन दी फिफ्थ अध्याय ऑफ छांदोग्य उपनिषद. सो इन दी सेम प्लेस वेर दिस द अर्लियर मंत्रास दे आर इन दी फोर्थ सेक्शन ऑफ दी फिफ्थ चैप्टर ऑफ छांदोग्य. एंड इफ यू गो फर्दर दैट इज वाक्यशेष. वाक्यशेष इज वॉट? इन दी 10th section of the 5th chapter. So from the 4th section you move further to the 10th section, you will see Vakyashesha. The travel which is mentioned in the Panchagni Vidya, it is of which Purushas? So those Grahasthas who were Jivas earlier in the earlier Janma, or Jivas who were Grahasthas earlier in the earlier Janma, and they did what? Grame Grahasthaha इष्टापूर्ते दत्तम इति उपासते. दे हैव डन दिस उपासना विथ इष्टापूर्त कर्म. व्हाट इज इष्टापूर्त? अग्निहोत्रम तपस्सत्यम वेदानां चानुपालनम आतिथ्यम वैश्वदेवश्च इष्टम इत्यभिधीयते. इष्टकर्म इज व्हाट? अग्निहोत्र, तपः, सत्य, देन फॉलोइंग वेद, वेदानां च अनुपालनम, फॉलोइंग वेदास, आतिथ्यम सर्विंग दि अतिथि before having food, one should not cook for oneself. Being a grihastha, he should cook for others also. And before having food, one should ask others around or go out and yell out, it seems, early in the earlier setup. Culturally, one should make an announcement, I am going to have food. Anyone else, is anyone hungry? Then that atithyam, to serve them, to feed them, and then one should have food. Vaishvadevascha, Vaishvadeva karma, and then all these are what? Ishtam, ishtam iti abhidhiyate. Then what about purta? Vapi kupa tadagadi devata yatanani cha anna pradanam arama purta mityabhidhiyate. Atithyam is serving the atithis, and then some parallel is there in purta karma also. So vapi kupa tadagadi, all these water bodies for people as well, making these water bodies, well, if you have a well, then making it open to others also, or digging wells, making water bodies, ponds, etc., for animals and birds, for human beings to drink water. Then devata yatanani cha. So basically what? Worshipping the deities as per the Smriti Granthas. Then anna pradana, feeding the poor, feeding hungry, basically whoever is hungry, all life forms which are hungry, anna pradanam aramaha, then helping them relax. So building parks, etc., donating to parks, or you know, constructing benches in park, etc., all these are basically or in the earlier setup they have used to have this dharmashala ityadi. Purtam ityabhidhiyate, that is purta. So whoever does this, they get punya, and they are the ones who are going to travel. Otherwise, it is meaningless that the Vedas talks about these, and then one who has reached Dyuloka is someone else. It is not the jiva at all. Sharanagata santranam bhutanam cha apyahamsanam bahirvedi cha yaddanam dattam ityabhidhiyate. Dattam, so dattam is another karma there. Ishtapurte dattam ityupasate. That I have given datta, I have done purta, I have done ishta karma. So ishta karma, purta karma, and datta is what? Sharanagata santranam. One who has taken sharana, even it is a shatru, one who takes refuge into you, you have to protect him, santranam. Bhutanam cha api ahimsanam. Ahimsa unto bhutas. All these are on Bahirvedi cha. Bahirvedi meaning dana outside the Vedas. In the Vedas, Dakshina is mentioned, that is part of the Ishtadi karma. But outside that, giving dana, yad danam, Bahirvedi cha yad danam, dattam, that is dattam. So ahimsa dana, rakshana dana, and dana outside the yagadi, Dakshina, that is called as dattam. Iti upasate te dhumam abhisavanti. They attain this dhuma marga. Ityadi vakyasheshena ishta purta karmakarinam jivanam. Jivanam ityartha. Pratitehe ityartha. There is a pratiti of jivas alone, not anyone else. So if you read the vakyashesha, then the entire panchagni vidya is actually talking about the jiva. So it is like having discussed everything, all the details of the karma you know, but then you do not know the main tattva itself, that all this discussion is surrounding the jiva alone. Who is travelling by this Dhumadi Marga? Who is the one who has the Janma here after the Punyakshaya, and then Dyuloka onwards there is a journey? All this is a talk of this Gamana of that very Jiva who has done karma and claims the phala. So Ishtapurta Karma Karinam, Ishtapurta Adipadena Datta also, Ishtapurta Datta Karma Karinam Pratite Rityartha Jivanam Pratitehe. So you cannot say that Jiva word is not heard. There is no Shruti, but Linga is there. You can see that Linga is there. Thereby, Jiva alone is being discussed there. We'll continue in the next part, huh? With the 7th Sutra. Amna yantika samsiddham adi madhyanta varjitam anandhanama purnam atma jyoti rupasmahe. We'll see how this leads to Vairagya as the Adhyaya flows. नमस्ते धन्यवाद.